I study gender gaps in STEM, so why women are underrepresented in many STEM fields, including computer science, physics, and engineering. Right now, there's a lot of social barriers that prevent girls and women from seeing themselves in these fields, but we can change the culture of these fields and the perception, the stereotypes that students have of these fields, and then get them to enter fields that they previously might not have considered. And one of the ways to do that is to change the images that are associated with these fields, and I think Barbie affords us one way to do that. Mattel is interested now in empowering girls, trying to get girls to put careers on the table that they hadn't previously considered. Katherine Johnson's a great example. When you see the representations of real women who've made a difference, you know, and really been on the path for female empowerment, I think it could be a very powerful message that they're sending. I think she's the best of the ones I have. I think, you know, she's got that NASA badge and that cute dress, and her arms and legs are movable, and robotics engineer Barbie. She's got sneakers on, you know, she's not wearing heels to lab, thank goodness, you know, and, you know, she's got clothes that are cute but not overly feminine, and she comes in different races, which is nice too. I think they could have made the robot cuter, but other than that, I think the doll itself is they did a nice job with it. This is an opportunity to have a lot of influence directly on girls and many boys. It's fun to be able to take the evidence that I've amassed, both from my own work, but also from a lot of other researchers out there in psychology and other social sciences who've been studying this.